NBC2 is tracking your tax dollar. A bill goes into effect January 1st, removing the tax on tampons and other feminine products. NBC2's Devin Turk uncovered the high cost of notifying business owners about this change. Devin.
Yeah, well, cutting taxes on feminine hygiene products is expected to save taxpayers $11 million a year. But some businesses say the state is wasting money notifying them again and again of that upcoming change.
It's aimed to put more money back in the pockets of Floridians.
It's a good thing for, I mean, if you're struggling to pay bills, a couple cents once a month makes a difference.
You take a 45-year-old woman who's been on tampons a majority of her life and all the tax that she's paid throughout her life on that, that money will accumulate.
But the cost to taxpayers to notify businesses has some scratching their heads.
I wouldn't think in the modern day and age that it's absolutely necessary to do this. It seems a little ridiculous and overkill.
Every year, the state mails businesses their tax-exempt list.
Items that are will no longer be taxed than the current items that are not taxed.
This year's list included the new tax exemption for feminine hygiene products, but multiple local businesses say the state sent out an additional letter in the mail just outlining this change.
They were identical. That's what was a little strange about it.
They never do that. This is the first time I've ever seen them send out a letter on a specific item. It's usually just included in the list.
Pharmacist TJ DePaula says his vendor also emailed him about the change. That means he was notified three separate times.
Well, I think they could have streamlined it. And they didn't need to go three different avenues to get one message across.
Now, the state says they mail letters and email businesses registered to sell feminine hygiene products. We asked multiple times how much money they spent to inform businesses of this change, but we were unable to get a clear answer. Live in the studio, Devin Turk, NBC2.